everybody just felt at ease and comfortable. The orchestra in Hanover has such a light way of interpreting classical music, and it's just, it's exactly how I hear it in my head. Everything just clicked, and there was this beautiful connection between everyone.
Annelien is lovely to work with because she can be the soloist coming and playing and everyone goes, gosh, but she wants to be part of the orchestra. So she's literally in the middle of the orchestra, for Mozart as well. For this album, she's standing in the middle of the orchestra with the musicians around, and it's a very collaborative atmosphere that she brings in, and the orchestra loves it, of course, and I do as well.
I decided to combine both Mozart and then Wim Henderickx, the yoga concerto, and call the combination of both flow. And so an old piece that people know, and then a very modern one. So I thought it could be exciting to just offer it all together.
We have to be courageous, I think, as musicians, as composers, but maybe also as programmers, and also as an audience, we have to be courageous and try to reinvent ourselves and reinvent new things, what we can do, also with this beautiful repertoire of the past.
Well, it's a late piece of Mozart, and it's one of the first great pieces for clarinet. You could say it is the greatest piece for clarinet. So it's a masterpiece in both senses. A great composer and writing for an instrument that's in a way is quite new as a concert instrument, and writing so beautifully, such a sublime piece. So it's very special in all ways.
So the choice to record Mozart's clarinet concerto with NDR Radio Philharmonie was actually a very obvious one. Because I know Andrew Menzi now since a few years. We were on tour together, and I liked his energy and the way he's actually working with the musicians in the orchestra so much that I thought, okay, this is exactly what I would like to hear. For me, playing Mozart concerto, even after so many times, I can really get into this, what I call flow state on stage, which is actually very similar to meditation and practicing yoga or just, you know, doing music with people and all have the same energy, the same breath. And so I thought it would just really match, especially because there's this connecting point of the basset clarinet in between.
You almost hear it as a different instrument because of the way the composers use it. You could say Mozart is more like an opera singer telling a story to the audience, and Mim is much more, you're sort of going into a temple and there's a monk sitting in the corner playing, and you're eavesdropping and listening to this monk chanting and playing, and literally Annelien sometimes is almost singing or speaking. I mean, it's like being witness to something very private. It's beautiful. The pieces sound nothing like each other, but there's something so right about each one that Mozart creates a world from the opening notes, and then you go and live in that world. It's beautiful. Wim Henderickx does exactly the same. He's an absolute master of creating an atmosphere that's like a world I've never been to before, and yet I know all about it from what he's written.
The big common thing between yoga and music is definitely connection. We really need this for the world, this kind of concerto. I was also very much interested to have a composition for the basset clarinet, because there's basically only the Mozart clarinet concerto written for the instrument, and it's such a precious instrument that I thought it was just absolutely the right thing to do, to commission a piece. So I was lucky, the Borletti-Buitoni Trust helped, and also BBC Radio 3, they loved the idea, and so that's how the commission started. Who could possibly write this concerto? And I was thinking, oh, probably an Indian composer or and it was actually so obvious because I'm Belgian myself, and in Belgium there's Wim Henderickx, and he's writing pieces based on all these themes since 30 years. So it was very logical to ask Wim, and he was very, very busy. And you know, normally a composer would tell you, oh, call me back in 5 years and we'll talk about it. But he loved the idea and he said, okay, that's exactly what I would like to do. So that's how the whole piece, yeah, started to become alive. The name of the concerto, Sutra, comes from a book, a person called Patanjali. He was a yogi and he would explain exactly what yoga is to his students. So the students actually, they wrote down little notes, small sutras.
I build it up in four movements, four different movements. The first is the pranayama, which is the breath of life. And then it comes the meditation, so the idea of taking a rest, going inside of yourself. And then in the third movement, it's a kind of really outburst of energy. When you do yoga, there is always an energy. And the third movement is a thrilling movement full of crescendos and rhythmical gestures. In this last movement, the fourth part, it's one relaxation to really come into a kind of almost like beautiful aesthetical sound world. So I really wanted to make a journey with the audience.
The last movement of the concerto is called Samadhi. It's actually the highest state a yogi could reach in his practice. So it's not a very conscious state, a little bit like in a flow. So yeah, if you want to find out how it feels, just listen to the album, I would say.